The country where I am from is called chaos. Everyone speaks the language of war. Every tribe a master of the craft of violence. You would think murder was fine art the way boys have learned to draw guns. The country where I am from is the bloody debate, an argument. Every man stands for himself or falls by the sword. The country is a house with death constantly knocking on the door. 100 banks till nothing is safe. The promised future is bleak and days remain the same. From mass murders to mass loops and sterile leaders whose ideas never produce fruits. Screams of anguish and sighs of regret are a peculiar sound. Call it country music. The country is a stage with the wrong musics. The country where I am from is a slaughterhouse. Hold Benway to the light. Show me what else best defines genocide. Xenophobes in South Africa haven't found a place this nasty sea. The country is plastic, fake, nothing is real. You can never get a clear picture. Everything seems photoshopped, from the manifestos to the president's age. And let me drop this real quick. The leadership is a mess. Its last name should be flatulence. The treaties and bills are staged. They take maximum salaries but haggle minimum wage like it was a market commodity, and I have come of age to understand that the promised Messiah is a revolution. And I demand to rest on my shoulders and the oil on my head, for I am a ticking time bomb hanging around my necks. So I take every step with boldness, knowing I have been blessed with the gift of 1,000 architects. So the battle line, before now, Doc was the name of a bird to guns came. Now when I hear Doc, I get goose pimples, and it's not just me. Majority of my people thought machines would help overcome work till machine guns came and overcame us. Now every single word that comes from the radio sounds like war. The news, the commercials and their songs, their lyrics are just so wrong. So permit me to write mine and sing for myself, because when I talk about the revolution, I speak for myself. Because I see young boys run for their lives whilst old men run for president. And we hold the truth to be self-evident that the devil we seek to fight is in our residence. And like a discharge and acquitted suspect, the truth comes to us free of every charge. But we choose to buy lies, giving them opportunities to plunder our lives. And they used to see change. Change is now a scary word, like Bob Marley's hair with dreadlocks. With eyes blinded to the real thing, what do we know about justice? About having the word to just ease. When the justice system jumps you like monkeys in jumpsuit, judges want your bananas. I mean bribes that will buy them vacation tickets to the Bahamas. In place of agriculture, we have learned to export loot. And the only thing we seem to import effortlessly are the naked foreign girls in music videos. Someone needs to tell us the truth. We are lost. Someone needs to blow the whistle, but no. Instead, like friends to a Facebook status, all we do is react. We never act. It's like we've signed a pact or entered into a blood covenant with silence. We have boys who don't do music but scale faces trying to steal ballot boxes. And our runs girls not feel race for us Olympics. And there is a thing about politics that ticks me off. It's the lies. You see, like the zeros and the billions they steal, their promises are full of holes. They make you work 9 to 5 and then 5 to 9, but the take home pay never takes you home. You do as much as pray, but like evil spirits, they keep possessing your possessions. Your child's education is on go slow like a funeral procession. And then the statement that the police is your friend is just another reminder that Judas was also a disciple. And that bail is free gives them opportunities to bail out on the truth. And I know you are forced to wonder how they manage to leave us and the economy in a sovereign state whilst they live up the capital. It is because the truth has no gain where it lies, the capital. Every of that press release is filled with a plethora of excuses. Excuse me, we aren't listening. Because we have graduates who end up mopping floors when they should be breaking new grounds. And we keep building new soldiers, but put them under our commands. I say it's time we demand our freedom. Shalom aleikum.